Bill. Okay. Let's do this thing. All right. Top tips for better battery life on iPhone. Now, what we're going to cover today, let's get some ground under our feet and figure out what we're going to be talking about. First of all, I want to go over a workshop goal. That's the main thing that I want you all to receive at the end of this workshop. Number two, I want to check your battery health with you. This is an iOS 11.3 feature that's new, and it is in regards to the battery throttling controversy Apple had recently. So we're going to cover that and also check out the health of your battery so you can see whether or not you should be taking advantage of the discounted battery. And then after we've covered all that, we've got five tips that will improve your battery life overall. So these are things that you can change in your settings. And then we're going to talk just a few minutes about how you can find more battery life info with iPhone Life. Then we'll have our wonderful Q&A and call it a day. So let's jump right in. All right, workshop goal. So what I want to do today is give you the tools to increase your iPhone or iPad's battery life regardless of the device you own. So the first couple things are iOS 11.3, but if you have an earlier, like let's say you have an iPhone 5 and it can't have iOS 11.3, then don't worry about it. The five tips that most of the workshop will be on will totally fit for every device. So everyone with a device, regardless of what it is gonna get something out of this. All right, let's keep going. How to check your iPhone's battery health and should you disable battery throttling? We'll look at your options. So checking battery health. Now this is a screen you're only gonna see if you have iOS 11.3. Okay, so the first thing you want to do, open your settings, select battery, tap battery health, and look at the maximum capacity. If it's 90%, if it's 100%, then you won't have the option to turn off battery throttling because there's no battery throttling happening. But if it's under 80%, then I highly, highly recommend taking advantage of Apple's offer. Typically, a replacement battery when you don't have a warranty or Apple Care would be $79. But through December 31st, 2018, you can get it replaced for just $29. So that's a huge difference. And Apple makes it pretty easy to get that replaced. You can send it into the store via a local authorized UPS store or have Apple send you a box and then you can send it out to them if you don't have a UPS store or you're far away from an Apple store. You can take it into an Apple store or you can take it to an authorized Apple repair shop. So there's a lot of options. If you do have an Apple Care Plus plan or your phone is on warranty, then it will be free. So John says he doesn't see anything under the battery health beta. When I click on it, you just get a link to an Apple page. That is peculiar, John. Michael says he has 84%. Sarah's gonna check that out, John, by the way. 84%, you're right on the edge there. You might consider getting a battery replaced. So the eligible devices for the $29 are the SE, the iPhone 6, 6 Plus, 6S, 6S Plus, 7, 7 Plus, 8, 8 Plus, and the 10. If you have a model outside of that, it's still the $79, unfortunately. 97%, Peggy, is fantastic. That's a really, really good battery still. Patricia, you aren't supposed to see the, am I supposed to see questions others are answering? So we have the chat on private, so we see all of your questions, but we didn't want to have this big overflowing chat going on. If that's something you prefer, let us know in the Facebook group and maybe we'll turn it on next time. All right, so let's move on to part two. 40% is rough. For audio, I don't understand, Sherry, I'm sorry. All right, part two. So hopefully you're with me and you are able to look at this battery health section. 85, 84%, I would go ahead and get it replaced. Otherwise, if it's below 80%, then you're gonna have the option to disable throttling. So that's gonna be difficult to see, but it is there. If you look at this screenshot that we have up, the peak performance capacity gives you like a little paragraph. And then in real small blue letters, it says disable. There are a couple points I wanna go over in regards to the throttling. If you have this option available to you to disable throttling, then definitely get your battery replaced at that $29. Because if you're seeing that, then it means your battery has degraded enough that your phone would benefit from a new battery. If you do disable that, then you might experience performance shutdowns. And if you experience a shutdown, it will automatically turn back on. That's maybe not ideal, you know, because you can't toggle it on and off as you please, but that's how it is for now. And Apple does have this all in beta, so I'm hoping that these features will improve and become more user-friendly as time goes on. Throttling, Rob, it's just like a fancy way of saying Apple is purposefully reining back the performance capabilities of the phone so that it doesn't get overloaded. On older phones, like, that battery is so important for performing everything that the newer iOSs need to do. And what happens when they throttle it is it's like it allows the phone to run these newer iOSs, but that puts more strain on the battery. I hope that clears that up. When Anita is saying when she updated to 11.3.1, she gets the beta page. Yes, it's all still in beta. Rob said, excellent, thank you, I'm so glad. All right, let me just check real quick, make sure I didn't forget any important information. So yeah, the only other thing I would say about this is I don't recommend disabling the throttling. Other people at iPhone Life might disagree with me on that, but I don't recommend it because if you're seeing the option to disable it, go get that $29 battery. Like, it's only there until December 31st, 2018. And if you're not planning on getting a new phone very soon, then you're definitely gonna wanna go ahead and take advantage of that offer. All right. So now let's move into five changes that will improve your battery life overall. The first tool I want to give you is the ability to see which apps are draining your battery. Now, when you look at this page, there are two main things that I want you to look for. The first is if there are any apps that you have that are using a lot of battery, but you aren't often using that app. You know what I mean? Like, for example, here, Game of Life. I have a game addiction. And 49% is how much I used and played Game of Life. But let's say that Facebook was popping up and I have not been on Facebook in 3 weeks. Then you know that Facebook is draining something in the background. And if you find an app that's doing that, I recommend deleting it. And if you need the app back, re-downloading it. Sometimes just that will help things. And this is also a good place to kind of get a reality check on where you are using your battery. Like for me, if I'm having a bad battery day, but I've been playing a game for a couple hours, like that's my fault. And I need to be aware of that. So to check these, you're going to open settings, select battery, and under battery usage, you can see what percentage of your battery the app has used, either in the last 24 hours or 7 days, based on which of these two tabs you select. And then you can also tap the clock icon to see the specific time. Like for example, the Game of Life, 41 minutes on screen tells me that like, that's my fault. But if I see, like for music, you see 16 minutes in the background, that's a different thing. That was happening in the background. It's not me being on screen and doing it. So this just, you're probably not going to see anything surprising here. It's more so just to give you an idea of where that battery is going before we alter the settings. All right. So this is my favorite tip to tell anyone who's asking for battery life tips. I call it the big bad wolf of battery drain, and that is background app refresh. This is a very sneaky feature because we often open a lot of apps and then we close the app, but we don't fully close the app. And that's not an issue if background app refresh is off. But if it's on, then all of those apps in the background of your phone are draining battery. And they're doing this because they're constantly trying to refresh. For example, let's say you open the Instagram app. When you open it, if it's off, background app refresh is turned off, then it takes like a minute to refresh your feed. If it's on, then your phone has been refreshing that feed over and over in the background so that when you open the app, you see the most recent stuff. So I love telling people to turn this off because it's not something that you normally need. There are a couple apps that might require it. And in that case, I recommend leaving it on and then individually toggling it off for all the apps that you don't need it for. Yes. And check this setting. Every time you update to a new iOS, like when iOS 12 comes out, check this. Because I noticed that when I upgraded to iOS 11, Apple had default turned it back on. So just be aware of that. So to do this, you're going to open your settings, tap general, select background app refresh, tap it again, and select off. You can turn it on for Wi-Fi if you're at home. And when you're at home, you often have it off anyway. You can totally do that. But I just like to have it off. And I recommend that if you don't mind it. So let me just glance over here at this chat real quick, see if there's anything. Cool, just learned something new, Rob said. That's amazing. How can I fully close an app? Is that when you flick it up off the screen? Yes, it is. Sarah, will you add that and we can go over that toward the end? We will get to that question. That's a great question. All right. What about if using maps while traveling? Very good question. Maps is not so much in relation to background app refresh. You could, if you're concerned about it, leave it on and toggle it off for everything else. But for maps, it's more so the location services that need to be on. I've never had any issues with having this feature off and using maps. Okay, let's move on to tip number 3. And this is actually 3 and 4. So this one is less earth-shaking, you know? It's not like background app refresh that to me was just life-changing. These are smaller things that you can pretty easily do. The first one is your screen brightness. Your display uses the most energy probably of anything on your phone. And so if you don't mind the brightness being reduced just a bit, that's going to help quite significantly. Obviously, you want it to still be a comfortable brightness, like you don't want to be looking at a dark phone. But if you can just reduce that just a bit, it will help. And then if you have, let's see, which phones is it? If you have an iPhone SE, 6S, 7, 7 Plus, 8, 8 Plus, or 10, you can also toggle off raise to wake. This is another one that's probably not going to make a giant difference, but like if you're someone who walks around with your iPhone a lot, if you just have it on your person often, then I recommend turning this off. Like mine's usually sitting on a desk, so it's not such a big deal. But if you're moving and walking around and it's in your hand, then you're triggering that raise to wake, and that's going to drain more battery just because the screen's having to bright up constantly. All right, let me just check over in chat real quick. All right. Rob, I'm going to ask Sarah to add that night shift for saving battery to the Q&A at the end as well. Oh, Zareen is asking, what does raise to wake do? Great question. Raise to wake, when it's on, it's just you pick up your phone and the screen automatically turns on. Yeah, that's it. Yeah, of course. So happy to help. Now, are we ready for tip five? All right. Location services. This is another one that can be earth shaking. It can make a huge difference. And that's because if you have an app open that is using location services, it's like gotta ping to towers. And anytime your phone needs to like constantly ping out, it's gonna that battery life. So for this, there are definitely going to be apps that you want to leave it on for, such as Maps. I leave it on for day one journaling app because I like to know the location. That's a more of a personal preference. Overall though, I like to select while using. So when you open settings, you tap privacy, you select location services, and then you have to do this by individual apps, unfortunately, but it's worth it. You go app by app and you'll have the option always, which means the app is allowed to always know your location while using, which means the app is allowed to know your location while you're using it, or never, which means it can never know your location. For any app that you don't need location services at all, definitely select never. For me, that's 80% of my apps, and I noticed a significant battery life increase when I switched that 80% of my apps to never. And then I would say, like, for me, 25%, did I just do math wrong? Maybe like 15% are selected while using, and that is like the day one app, or I can't think of another app right now, but apps that you generally just need it to know your location for one reason or another. And then I would say the only always would be like Maps. Look at this question by Anita. Does choosing while using really decrease battery life? Yes and no. No, because while using will only drain battery life when you're in the app, as long as background app refresh is turned off. I hope that that line of thought follows and makes sense. If you had background app refresh on while using, would suck up a lot more battery life. But with that off and with while using, it's worth the bit of drain that you're going to get for the apps that will need it, I would say. And for the apps that don't need it, it's not worth it. So it's a very app by app decision that you kind of have to make. Let's see. Find iPhone only has while using and never. So how do you find it when it's off? While using and never. Yeah, oh, that's a good point Sarah just made. Not all the apps are going to have all the three options. For Find My iPhone, I would definitely choose while using. I would not choose never, just in case, you know. Anike here. Oh, that's for later. I will save it. If you have set to off, what does an app do to request it be turned on? Great question. When you first download an app, Darren's asking, if you have it set to never, what does an app do to request that location services be turned off? When you first download an app, it will request your location. After the fact, it probably won't. Like if you say no or you disable it, the app probably, unless it needs it, probably won't ask for location services to be turned on again. But you can always go in settings and turn it on if you need to. Frank is saying sound is extremely distorted. Is this better? I hope. what was the last one? What about the last one? System services. System services at bottom of list has many options. Darren says sound is good. Sarah's going to look into the system services thing. I don't know that off the top of my head. All right. So location services is tip number 5. All right. I had to include this bonus tip. This is another tip. And it's a bonus tip because it's not going to work for everyone. But for the people that are cool with it, it could make a pretty significant difference. And if you have an older device, I would say bite the bullet and definitely turn this on. So what reduce motion does, if you are on your phone, just like go to home screen real quick or open up an app and notice that there's an animation that makes that really seamless. As you open something up, it's just like, it feels like really natural that it's opened that way, if that makes sense. And that's actually an animation that Apple has built in. So what you can do is turn off reduce motion. And instead of things like kind of sliding in and out, it'll just fade between the screens. And that's gonna reduce your battery significantly. Reduce battery drain significantly. And that's just because those animations are in everything. A really good thing, though, is like if you really enjoy the message effects, I know with iOS 10, it was an issue with turning on reduce motion, wherein by turning it on, you couldn't use message effects anymore. And that was fixed with iOS 11.3. So you can go into settings, select general, select accessibility, tap reduce motion, toggle reduce motion on. And when you do, another option will pop up. And if that second option is toggled on, then you can also still use the message effects. Excuse me. Okay. While using meant for using app or using phone. Real quick, Anike, while using is while using app, not while using phone. Very good clarifying point. All right. So really, this is just a taste of what fantastic information we have to offer. And we actually have another article that has like 4 to 5 more tips on battery life. I will include that in the Facebook group after this. If you would like to discuss more things, then you can head on over to our Facebook group afterwards, and I'll be there for at least half an hour. And good to post these items after. We'll also have this recording available on our website and in the Facebook group, so you can go back through it if you would like. It will be archived for future playback. And what is the Facebook group? So the Facebook group is very new. It's over at, I believe, facebook.com/groups/iPhoneLifeMag. Don't quote me on that, but that's very close. You can find it on Facebook just by searching iPhone Life Group. It's pretty much just a hub. Like there's no super specific purpose. You don't have to be part of any of our programs to join it. It's just a place where anyone can come, ask a question. There's over 1,800 people there that are engaged and super helpful. I've been so amazed to see how wonderful you all are. And it's just been a blast to engage with you all directly on a daily basis, and you can join us there. It's just called, you know what? I'm gonna have Sarah drop a link in the chat box, and then that will take you there right quick. She just gave me a look like, what? I'm so glad it's been helpful.
For the Facebook group?
For the Facebook group, yeah. Oh, I'm so happy you love the iPhone tips, Mary. I just shook everything with my happiness. All right. And the repeat webinar, you can find at iPhoneLife.com. Not immediately, but definitely soon. Give it like a day or two. Make it Monday. And we'll definitely have it. Oh, I'm getting so much love. You guys are so sweet and amazing. All right. Thank you so much. Okay. So I just want to share a little quick, if you'll stick with me for this, iPhone Life Insider. Now, we are so passionate about this program. And I think 2018 is going to be the year to sign up because we've got some amazing things in the work. Our editor-in-chief, Donna, and our designer, Jamie, puts so much love and work into the in-depth video guides. These are in-depth video guides and collections, usually around 20 videos per, and you can also download them as a PDF. You can tune in, learn for 5 minutes, or spend a couple hours, whatever works with your schedule. It's all video, so you're walked through step by step for each and everything. It makes it really easy. They're also super beautiful and just a lot of fun. Like, we do various things from iPhone photography to Apple Watch to iCloud. We've done Facebook, and coming this fall, iOS 12 will be coming out, and we'll have this just like full guide ready for you when iOS 12 comes out. That's just going to make the transition so easy. Something that our current insiders tell us they love is the daily tips. So I think a lot of you are probably very familiar with the daily tip newsletter. And insiders actually get a video of that tip every day. So they can look through and see exactly how to do it right on their phone via the screen. And then every Saturday, you get a little video with me, and I feature an app every week. So you'll get that in your inbox every Saturday. It also gives you access to this huge archive. There's over 700 video tips there. So any question, any tip you want to look up, anything you're having trouble with, there's just a huge, huge resource there that you can dive into. If you're a fan of the magazine, you have unlimited access to every issue of the magazine. Like, I'm talking 2014, 2012, all the way through this year. When the fall issue comes out, you'll just automatically have access to it. And it also has all the links in there. So if you're going through and you're like, ooh, I want to learn more about this, you just tap on it and you're there. It's so cool. And you can view it on all of your devices, your iPad, your iPhone, your computer. It just makes the whole experience really together in a single place that you can just appreciate and like absorb all the information you want. Last but definitely not least, you have direct access to this wonderful woman sitting next to me. She answers all of your questions directly in the Ask an Editor portion of Insider. This is just, I mean, an invaluable resource to have. If you have something that you can't find an answer to, send it to Sarah and she will figure it out. And it's, I would love to convey to you guys like how hard we as a team work on this and how much joy it brings us to present this to you and hear how much you love it. So check it out if you're interested. iPhoneLife.com/insider. It is $9.99 a month or 50% off for the $59.94 a year price. So check it out. No pressure. But if you're into it, definitely sign up. Definitely join. And we are so excited to keep connecting with you. This is going to be one of many workshops as well. All right. Q&A time. Q&A time. Sarah's going to join us.
Hey, everyone.
All right. So now let me check at our reservoir of questions over here. So Rob had asked, What about night shift for saving battery? That makes sense. Yeah, that makes a lot of sense because it's reducing the blue light of your screen. I don't feel like keeping that on all day is going to necessarily make such a large difference.
Might help your sleeping.
Definitely help your sleeping. I think it can't hurt to put it on, you know, once the sun starts to go down a little bit. I enjoy it and really like it for different reasons, but yeah, I don't think it's going to make a huge difference, but it's worth it.
Some of our participants are asking to explain night shift, and David is saying he thinks night shift takes up more battery.
Oh, interesting. Our CEO thinks it takes up more battery. So I could be wrong. Night shift, let me explain night shift real quick. It is, and another thing, let me go ahead and switch over to my iPhone so I can show y'all where to find night shift. All right, share. Okay, so night shift is, science has shown that when you're using your devices at night, the melatonin in your brain can't really do its job. It can't be released, partially due to the blue light from screens. So night shift is a way to reduce the amount of blue light in your screen. And it gives it just like a kind of a faint orangey glow. It's not distracting or like weird looking. It's just very faint. You can subtly see the difference. I really, really like it, especially at night. So to find night shift, open your settings, go to display and brightness, select night shift, and then you can actually schedule it to start at like 6 p.m., 7 p.m., whatever you prefer, and run until like 7 a.m. Or you can manually enable it till tomorrow. Unfortunately, you can't see the difference in the screencast, but as I just turned it on, I immediately saw a difference. And you can choose more warm or less warm. So I would expect that more warm will take up more battery, but that the center, I'd be surprised if it took up more battery. I can definitely look into that and answer it assuredly in the Facebook group, though. Ooh, Nicole. I'm going to say thank you for Sarah. She loves your earrings.
They're for my Mrs. Frizzle costume. They're Adam.
She was Mrs. Frizzle for Halloween. It was amazing. All right. Let's see. What other questions do we have? Are there any that you have come across, Sarah, that I should...
I put them in that channel and put some for you to find.
Okie dokie.
I've been taking all your requests and questions and putting them in a place for Connor to look at them.
Yes. So Chris asked, will it be possible to watch this same video again? Yes, it will, Chris. We're going to put this video in the Facebook group and on our website by Monday. In the future, we plan to put these... an insider. So that would be like part of the offering. But for this particular webinar, absolutely, it's going to be available pretty quickly across all of our platform channels, iPhoneLife.com and the Facebook group. So yeah. Andrew asked, when an app is updated, do the preferences set for location and background refresh re-enable themselves? In other words, do we have to constantly recheck after app updates, or are our choices persistent? That's a great question, Andrew. For updating apps, it's not such an issue. The location you might check every now and again. Background app refresh will not be affected by updating apps or downloading new apps. You only really need to check background app refresh after major iOS updates, like iOS 11, 12, and so on. For just regular app updating, I think you're pretty good. Yeah, you don't need to constantly check. I would just recommend on the major updates, definitely giving it a little peek and a little, and if you like download a lot of apps often, to check now and again, just because it's hard to know when you download an app what the settings that you've saved are. Rob asks, so if you had throttling, could opted for an older iOS. Sarah, can you help me with that? So if you had throttling, could opted for an older iOS? I don't understand.
I mean, do you mean like you could have not updated? Or, you know, some devices can no longer be updated past iOS 9 point, what was it, 3? The option to, you could always choose not to update your version of iOS. I think it's a bad idea because you're missing out on all the security updates that Apple also releases with those updates.
Good points.
So, and then, you know, the option to turn throttling on or off is only available for iPhone 7, 7 Plus, and I think down through 6. Correct?
Yeah. So Rob is saying he has a 5S.
Ah, okay. I don't know if that one's up. I don't know if it's option. It's an option for 5S. I think it's only 6 and above. So
yeah. But you can get your battery replaced with the 5S. It's not going to be at that discounted rate, which is ridiculous. But you know, I can't change that. If you plan on keeping the 5S for many more years, then I would go ahead and splurge on the $79 to replace your battery. Because it is being throttled. Even if it's not like an option to turn it off, I can pretty much guarantee that your battery has degraded and it is being throttled in some way. If your max capacity battery is 87% and it does not last more than 5 hours, go get that new battery.
Well, except for I would say go and check your battery usage. And I mean, like anytime I'm on Facebook, even though it doesn't seem like I'm on Facebook for a whole lot of hours, although probably I am, you know, I find certain things I do with my phone uses the battery a lot more. And I also find when I don't have good cellular connection, my battery gets used a lot more quickly too. So there could be other issues. And so it's worth checking into, but 87% is definitely borderline.
Yes. Nicole asks, why does my phone battery go down overnight even when I've closed all apps? For you, Nicole, I would try putting your phone on airplane mode. I'm going to go ahead and guess that you have an older phone. Like my mom has a iPhone 5 and it doesn't seem to matter what she does. It definitely goes down overnight, but her putting it in airplane mode has helped a lot. And if you do have an older phone and you can't tell how degraded the battery is, it becomes tough. Like if you can tell that the battery is definitely degraded and you have a new enough iPhone to get it replaced, do that for sure. If you can't tell and it is an older device and you plan to keep that older device for years to come, I would recommend go ahead and spend the $79 so that your older phone is still a very usable phone. You know what I mean? Becky, do I have to purchase the new battery at an Apple store or is it something I can order online and replace myself? Great question. You can't replace it yourself and you wouldn't want to, but you can send it into an Apple store or take it into an Apple store or an authorized repair shop. So like I live 2 hours away from an Apple store. So what I would want to do is opt for Apple to send me a box and then I send them my phone in the box and then they would repair it and send it back.
From painful experience, I would recommend sending it on a Monday so you get it back sooner instead of waiting all weekend without your phone.
Very good tip. Very, very good tip. Rob says, thanks for so much great info. Oh, thank you so much, Rob. I really do appreciate such wonderful words.
Yep. And Walter is backing me up on the cellular signal saying, you know, your phone is trying to maintain that connection so it boosts power. So that's definitely been my experience when I'm not having a good signal, my battery power. Like my daughter used all of our data. I refused to buy more data on principle. And so we were without data and I definitely noticed an impact on my battery life.
Yeah, that's a really good point.
And on my teenager's ability to use data in the future.
I want to get to Catherine's real quick. Do you know more about why the batteries were affected after the release of the new iPhones and why can't Apple fix what they messed up without customers having to replace their batteries? Very fair question. It's a couple things. I would say the first part is that the new iOSs are designed to work with faster, better processes, like
processors.
Like the iPhone 10 has the latest and greatest processor. So Apple is optimizing iOS 11 to work with the iPhone 8 and the iPhone 10. Whereas the iPhone 5, not only is it like an older processor and like older technology in general, it's older. So the battery will actually degrade over time. Is there any points that I'm missing to that as to why? It's not really Apple's fault, I think is what I'm trying to say. Like, I definitely understand why people are upset, but it was like an issue of like better battery life versus a really buggy phone. And the throttling is intended so that you don't have a buggy phone while you're using it, even though that cuts into your battery life. So it's kind of like a catch-22 in that way.
So a couple of people have asked at what point, like in your battery cycle throughout the day, you should recharge. Generally like 50, you know, like they say the optimal like range is like 50 to 80%, like keep your phone in that range. You know, but they continue improving the battery so that doesn't damage it as much.
Right.
So I pretty much just, you know, just like plug it in at night and use it during the day and top it up if I need to. And
yeah,
I don't know. I'm probably like damaging it, but not as much as you might have once had to. They used to be a lot more delicate.
Yeah, that's super true. If you have like, I would say the 6S and beyond, it's not as big of a deal, I think. If you have an older phone, I would say about 50%, go ahead and plug it in.
I mean, basically, you don't want to expose your iPhone to, you know, extreme temperatures. So like, you know, certain cases can cause your phone to overheat, especially when you're charging it.
Yeah, it's a good point.
Wireless charging with a case on can heat your phone up. Just like constantly draining it all the way. And, you know, like the more work you put your battery through, the shorter of a time it will last.
Yeah. Is it good to turn the phone off once a week or so? I don't think there's anything to that currently.
I mean, I like to turn I don't do it once a week, but whenever it starts kind of like acting buggy, and especially pretty much every time that I do a new iOS update, I always shut my phone down completely and restart it.
Yeah. If it's getting like a little slower than normal, like shut it down completely, give it a couple minutes and then repower it up. Otherwise you should be pretty good. Michael asks, is there any issue with leaving it on charge all night? No. If you were to leave it charged in like for a week, yes, because that's generally not good for any electronic device, but overnight shouldn't be any issue.
My understanding is, and I may be wrong, so if you know differently, pop in the comments, but is that Apple has basically made it so once your phone is fully charged, it stops charging.
Oh, there you go.
John wants to know, is it better to leave your phone face down? Well, you won't get your notifications. I mean, they won't like make as much, like it will sort of like mute your notifications. So
in that way, yes.
Yeah.
Because every time a notification comes in, your screen lights up and that will drain battery.
Right.
So yes, leave it face down if you can.
And John is saying his phone shuts down regularly and he can't get it replaced because he got it replaced from a certified dealer already. You can get it replaced. You can get as many battery replacements as you want, but you'll have to pay the full price. Mm. There may also be some other issue, so it might be worth having Apple look at it. It's up to you.
Yeah, totally. Are there differences in battery usage if I use Wi-Fi versus my carrier data? Yes. And this is because on carrier data, your phone is pinging out. It's trying to find the cellular signal from the towers, and that does use battery. So using Wi-Fi when you can is definitely the best way to go.
Right. And returning to charging your phone overnight, Walter just pointed out, or made a really good point, is you should leave it charging all night and in Wi-Fi so that your phone will automatically back up to iCloud, which is one of the number one things you should be doing with your phone, and so many people don't. You can go into just search iCloud in your settings menu if you don't know where it is, and go to and then find backup and turn that on. It's a really great idea. If something happens to your phone, all of your stuff will be saved in the cloud and you can put it on your new phone.
Yeah. All right, you guys. So been here about 45 minutes, so we're going to wrap it up. If you would like to ask us some more questions, join us in that Facebook group. And we'll be there for about half an hour. And I mean, I'm there quite often anyway. So any other questions you have, drop it in there. I'm also going to share our article that has like all 10 battery life tips. So if you're just hungry for more right now, you can check that out. Thank you so much. I just really want to appreciate all of you that are here and all of you that signed on and joined us for this workshop. Y'all are freaking amazing, and it really makes our day to interact with you in such a personal way and really get to know you all.
I really second that. You know, I do the podcast, and but that's like there's really no interaction, and so I'm so happy that Connor invited me to join her today, and it was really great to get to, you know, chat with you guys in real time. So thanks a lot for joining us.
Thank you. See you next time. Everyone.